Dear students, welcome to the session of geometry. So our topic is pair of straight lines. In the previous session we discussed an important theorem. If s equal 0 represent pair of parallel lines, then s square equal to ab and af square equal to b square, those are the conditions for the pair of parallel lines, and distance between them 2 into root of g square minus ac by a into a plus b, or 2 into root of f square minus bc by b into a plus b. In this session we will learn the equations forms a square and some applications, I mean distance between the parallel lines, and so two or three more problems miscellaneous type. Okay, right. First of all, we have to find out the distance between the parallel lines. Just to prove theorem, so here just one application on it. So here the equation, the given equation is what is the equation? 9x square minus 6xy plus y square plus 18x minus 6y plus 8 equal to 0. Just we have to find out the distance between the parallel lines. Here a is equal to 9, 2h is equal to minus 6, b is equal to 1, and g equal to 18, g equal to 9. 2f equal to minus 6, f equal to minus 3, c is equal to 8. So the distance between the parallel lines just we have two forms, we can use any one of these. So here I am using f square minus bc by b into a plus b. Okay, just substitute the values. 2 into what is the value of f? Minus 3 whole square minus b into c. What is b? 1, c means 8, whole divided by b into a plus b, that means 1 into a 9 plus b 1. So here this is nothing but 2 into square root of 9 minus 8 by 1 into 9 plus 1, 10. 9 minus 8, 1, that means 2 by root 10. Otherwise, we can write 4 by 10, that means 2 by 5. See this problem? Show that the two pairs of lines forms a square. So these are the given equations. We have to prove the angle between adjacent sides 90 and diagonals are perpendicular. Otherwise, all sides are equal and angle between adjacent sides 90. Any one of it, these two. Okay. First of all, observe these two equations. Here, homogeneous second degree parts are same. Therefore, it represents parallel pairs. Understand? So, clearly, first of all, going to this, just this represents two sides. Let us take O and O, say the two sides represented by 1. So, let us assume one represents the two sides OA and OC. Similarly, 2 represents AB and BC. And the equation 2 represents the two sides BA and BC. Okay, this equation represents these two sides, this equation represents these two sides. And at the same time, in 1 and 2, we observed that the homogeneous second degree parts are equal. And again, we observed that the homogeneous second degree parts are equal. Therefore, 1 and 2 represents two parallel pairs. That means these two equations represent four lines. In four lines, two are parallel. That means opposite sides are parallel. Okay, let it be. This is the first conclusion. 1 and 2 represent two parallel pairs. Okay, next, in both the equations, what about the coefficient of x square and coefficient of y square? Same. In both the equation, in both the equations, coefficient of x square is 3 and coefficient of y square is minus 3. This implies 3 plus minus 3 equal to 0. Therefore, this represent two mutually perpendicular lines. One represent perpendicular lines, two also represent perpendicular lines. Already one represent the two sides O and OC. This implies coefficient of x square plus coefficient of y square 0 means angle between O and OC is 0 in 90. This implies OA perpendicular to OC and BA perpendicular to BC. So understand. So here this equation represents these two sides. This represents perpendicular because coefficient of x square plus coefficient of y is 0. Therefore, angle between O and OC is 90. Similarly, angle between these two sides is 90 and opposite sides are parallel. That means angle between any two sides is 90. So OA perpendicular to OC and BA perpendicular to BC. Let it be B. From A and B equations, from A and B equations, A and B, so we can say the angle between any two adjacent sides is 90. From A and B, we can say angle between any two adjacent sides, any two adjacent sides are perpendicular. Any two adjacent sides perpendicular means just all angles are 90 degrees. So if the all angles are 90, angle between any adjacent sides 90, it may be square or rectangle. Okay, if the diagonals are perpendicular, it becomes square. If the diagonals are not perpendicular, it becomes rectangle. We have to prove that diagonals are perpendicular. So first of all, find out the diagonals, slopes of the diagonals. If you know the slopes of the diagonals, we can verify the perpendicularity. So now 2 minus 1 and combined equation of ABBC minus combined equation of OAOC gives the diagonal AC. Therefore, now find out 2 minus 1. 2 minus 1 gives 2 minus 1. These two parts are same. Just we will get only this one. Gives 2x minus 4y minus 1 equal 0. This equation represents the diagonal AC. This let it be 3. Clearly, 3 represents AC, diagonal AC. Slope of FAC equal to slope of AC is equal to minus 2 by minus 4, that is equal to 1 by 2. This is the slope of AC. Next, we want to find the slope of OB. How can you find? Just find out B. B is nothing but point of intersection of 2. So from 2, so B is equal to, what is the formula to find the coordinates of the point of intersection of the pair of lines? HF minus BG by AB minus H square, GH minus AF by AB minus H square. Already in the previous sessions, we discussed about the point of intersection of the pair of lines. In the change of x also, we derived formula for this. Okay, just put the values of all these terms and we will get the coordinates of the point B. Here just observe that 2hxy, 2h is equal to 8, h is equal to 4, 4 into f, 2fy, 2f equal to minus 4, f equal to minus 2, pg square, b equal to minus 3, and 2gx means g is equal to 1, the value of a is equal to 3, b equal to minus 3, and h is equal to 4, 4 square. So the denominators are same, so we should write same denominator. And g value of g is equal to 1, and h value is 4, a value is 3, the value of f is minus 2. So now the value is minus 8 plus 3, minus 5 by minus 9 minus 16, minus 9 minus 16 minus 25. So 4 plus 6, 10 by minus 25. This is equal to 1 by 5, comma 5 5 is 2 by 5. Minus 2 by 5. These are the coordinates of the point of intersection of 2. That means coordinates of B. Coordinates of B is equal to 1 by 5, comma minus 2 by 5. Slope of OB is equal to slope of y2 minus y1, this minus 0 by this minus 0, that means minus 2 by 5 minus 0 by 1 by 5 minus 0, that is equal to minus 2 by 5 by 1 by 5 minus 2. This is the slope of the diagonal OB, this is the slope of the diagonal AC. Therefore, let it be M1, let it be M2. Here M1, M2, just find out M1, M2 is equal to 1 by 2 into minus 2, this is equal to minus 1. Therefore, OB is perpendicular to AC. That means diagonals are perpendicular. Let it be some D. From C and D, we can say that the given pair of equation forms a square. C, clear the angle between the adjacent side. It shows the angle between any two adjacent side, 90. It may be parallelogram, rectangle or square, but the diagonals are perpendicular, so it becomes a square. From C and D, from equation C and D, we can say the given equations 1 and 2, equations 1 and 2 forms a square. This is the problem. Okay. So see this problem. Show that the lines this and this are concurrent. So the given equation of these two, this represents two lines. This is the equation of a line. There are three lines. We have to prove that concurrent. It is enough to prove that point of intersection of the lines represented by one satisfies this. Okay. So now first of all, find out the point of intersection of one. So first of all, what is the formula for point of intersection? So, coordinates of the point of intersection of 1 is nothing but hf minus bg by ab minus h square, gh minus af by ab minus h square. So, in the previous session, we discussed about this theorem. In change of x also, we have a formula. We have a proof for this. So, with the help of this formula, find out the point of intersection of 1. Okay, here, what about a, b, c and h, ghf? Just now compare this equation with the second degree general equation. Write down the values for the a, b, c and like that. A is equal to 1, 2hxy, that means 2h is equal to 2, and b is equal to minus 35, 2g is equal to minus 4, 2f is equal to 44, and c is equal to minus 12. Now substitute all the values in the above formula, we will get the point of intersection for 1. So here, h value is 2h equal to h equal to 1, f value is 22, HF minus BG, the value of G is minus 2 by AB minus H square, 1 whole square, the value of H is 1, therefore 1 whole square. So denominator for the second term also same, 1 into minus 35 minus 1 whole square. So the value of G is 2G, X, G equal to minus 2, the value of G is minus 2. GH, the H value is 1, minus AF, A value is 1 and F is 22. Okay, now simplify this. 22 minus 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 70 whole divided by minus 35 minus 1. So minus 35 minus 1 minus 2 minus 22. Okay, now write down the coordinates for this. 22 minus 70, 48 minus 48 by minus 36 and minus 24 by minus 36. So here also minus minus get cancelled. So understand? Now just what about this? 12 4 is 12 3 is 12 2 is 12 3 is. Therefore, the coordinates of the point of 1 is equal to 4 by 3, comma 2 by 3. Okay, now substitute the coordinates of this point in the equation 2. So, substitute in the equation 2 here 5 into whatever the x coordinate, 4 by 3. Plus 2 into y coordinate is 2 by 3 minus 8. Therefore, 20 by 3 plus 4 by 3 minus 8. So, 24 by 3 minus 8 is equal to 8 minus 8, 0. That means the point of intersection of 1, point of intersection of 2 lines representative 1, satisfying the 2. Therefore, so 1 and 2 are concurrent lines. See this problem. So these two equations forms a rhombus. If these two forms rhombus, show that A minus B into FG plus H into F square minus B square equal to 0. So draw a figure. OABC is a rhombus. OABC are the vertices. So the given equation of these two. We know that this represents a line, two lines passing through origin. Let us assume one represents the sides OA and OC. One represents OA and OC, and similarly 2 represents BA and BC. Okay, so with the help of rhombus we have to prove this condition. In rhombus, what is the condition? Diagonals are perpendicular, adjacent are not 90. So A plus B not 90. Okay, so with the help of diagonals perpendicular condition we have to prove this condition. First of all, try to find out the slopes of the diagonals. Okay, so we know the combined equation of ABC and combined equation of OAC. So now subtract 1 from 2. What will happen? 2 minus 1 gives, here the homogeneous second degree parts are same. So 2 minus gives only this part, that means 2gx plus 2fy plus c equal to 0. Let it be 3. This is nothing but a line, because first degree equation in x and y, it represents a line which is passing through point of intersection of these two. This is the resulting equation of these two, means this is passing through point of intersection of these two. These two point of intersections are here, A and C. Therefore, the equation 3 represents diagonal AC. Therefore, equation of the diagonal AC is equal to 2gx plus 2fy plus c equal to 0. Slope of the diagonal AC is equal to slope of the diagonal ఏసి ఇజ్ ఈక్వల్ టు మైనస్ టూ జీ బై మైనస్ టూ ఎఫ్ మైనస్ టూ జీ బై ఎఫ్ మైనస్ ఎక్స్ కోషన్ బై వై కోషన్ మైనస్ జీ బై ఎఫ్ లెట్ ఇట్ బి ఎమ్ వన్. So this is the slope of the one diagonal AC. Now we have to find out the slope of another diagonal OB. So coordinates of O 0 0. What about the coordinates of B? Coordinates of B nothing but point of intersection of 2. Therefore, the coordinates of B is equal to point of intersection of two. So what about the coordinates of the point of intersection of this equation? HF minus BG by AB minus H square, GH minus AF by AB minus H square. These are the coordinates of the point B. Already we know the coordinates of the point O, 0, 0. Now the slope of the diagonal OB. Slope of the AD is equal to y2 minus y1 by x2 minus x1. That means GH minus AF by AB minus H square minus 0 by this minus 0. HF minus BG by AB minus H square. So the denominator will get cancelled. So what about the slope? So the resulting slope M2 is equal to, this is the slope of the diagonal AB. Slope of the diagonal OB. M2 is equal to GH minus AF by HF minus BG. So slope of one of the diagonal, this is the slope of another diagonal. So find out, consider M1, M2 is equal to, we already given this is a rhombus. Consider M1, M2 equal to minus 1 because diagonals are perpendicular. So slope of the diagonals are product of the slopes of diagonals minus 1. Therefore, what is slope of AC? Minus G by F into GH minus AF by HF minus BG is equal to minus 1. This minus minus get cancelled. Just to simplify the numerator and denominator separately, G square H minus AGF is equal to HF square minus BGF. So what is the required condition? A minus B into FG, take FG common from these two and H common from these two. So here, so just bring from right to left, G square, here just observe that A minus B into FG is the required term. Just bring the left hand terms to right side, then we will get HF square minus BG into F plus AG into F minus G square H equal to 0. So now, so take FG common from these two, then we get A minus B into FG. From the last term and first term there is common H. So now take H common from the last term and first term. H into F square minus G square equal to 0. This is the required result. Just observe the result. This is the result. Understand? So A minus B into FG plus H into F square minus G square. This is the result. If these two equations represent, forms a rhombus, then those two equations must be satisfy this condition. Okay, see this problem. So before going to that, see the concept. Homogeneous in the second degree equation with first degree equation x and y. Homogenizing means we have to change the first degree terms into second degree. That means we have to convert the second degree equation, general equation, into homogeneous second degree equation. Okay, so just see the problem. Let us find the lines joining the origin to the point of intersection of the curve and line. That means, find the lines joining, suppose this is the curve, this is the line intersecting at A and B, this is the position of the origin, just join these two. Here we have to find out these lines, find the lines joining origin to the point of intersection of these two. That means this represent two lines passing through origin. Again, this represents the homogeneous second degree equation. Homogeneous second degree represents lines passing through origin. So we have to convert this equation into homogeneous second degree equation with the help of this. That means we have to convert this first degree terms into second degree terms with the help of this. So here, so the help is required for 2x, 2y, 4y and 8. Okay, so here already this is, these are the second degree terms. We have to change this first degree terms into second degree with the help of this. Here from this, we can write 1 is equal to 3x minus y by 2. Just we expressed a constant 1 value in terms of first degree terms. The every term is a first degree term. With the help of this, we have to change this equation into homogeneous second degree equation. So homogenizing 1 with respect to 2. Homogenizing 2. Okay, so what happened? So we will get the equation of OA OB. To obtain the combined equation on OA and OB, homogenizing 1 with respect to, just write down like that. Okay, so now take the first degree equation. 7x square minus 4xy plus 8y square plus 2x into, we have to improve one more degree, so into 1 minus, here also we have to improve one more degree by into 1, but this is a constant, we have to improve 2 degrees, so 8 into 1 square, just replace 1 by this value, we will get a second degree equation in x and y, homogeneous second degree equation. 7x square minus 4xy plus 8y square plus 2x into 1 means 3x minus y by 2 minus 4y into 1 means 3x minus y by 2 minus 8 into the value of 1 is 3x minus y by 2 whole square equal to 0. Okay, so here you can write 7x square minus 4xy plus 8y square. So here 2 get cancelled. Then we will get 3x square minus xy. Here also 2 times minus 6xy plus 2y square is equal plus, sorry, minus 8 into 3x minus y whole square by 4. So 4 to j. Just simplify this equation. Then we will get 7x square plus 3x square, 10x square next minus 4xy minus xy minus 5xy, 8y square plus 2y square, 10y square minus 2 into a minus b whole square minus 2 into 9x square plus y square minus 6yxy equal to 0. Now simplify this. 10x square minus 5xy plus 10y square minus 18x square minus 2y square plus 12xy equal to 0. So 10x square minus 18x square minus 8x square minus 5xy plus 12xy plus 7xy minus 5xy plus 12, minus 5 plus 12, 7xy has to 10y square minus 2y square, 8y square. Okay, so minus 12xy, this is minus 12xy minus 5xy. Okay, this is here we can write 8x square minus 7xy minus 8y square equal to 0. By simplification, we will get the required equation. That means combined equation passing through origin. Just to simplify it, 7x square minus 4xy plus 8y square plus x into 3x plus 3x square plus x into minus y minus xy minus 2y into 3x minus 6xy minus into minus plus 2y square and minus 8 into a minus b whole square 9x square plus y square minus 6xy whole divided by 4. 4 2 there. This is equal to 0. Just to simplify this equation. So 7x square plus 3x square 10x square. Just minus 4xy minus xy minus 6xy. Minus 4 minus 6 minus 10 minus xy minus 11xy. 8y square plus 2y square 10y square. Just multiplying by minus. Minus 18x square. Minus 2y square. Minus minus plus 12xy. So again simple for this. 10x square minus 8x square minus 8x square. Minus 11xy plus 12xy plus xy. 10y square minus 2y square plus 8y square. So here you can rewrite this equation. 8x square minus xy minus 8y square equal to 0. This is a homogeneous second degree equation xy. This represent two lines passing through origin. That means this is the equation of the line joining origin to the point of intersection. Okay, let it be 3. We have to find out the angle between them. So write down the formula for angle between them, cos theta. Cos theta equal to mod of a plus b by square root of a minus b whole square plus 4h square. So here the value of a is 8 and value of b is minus 8 by something that is equal to 0. Otherwise here also we can say that coefficient of x square plus coefficient of a square equal to 0. That means represent perpendicular lines. Therefore cos theta equal to 0, theta equal to 90 degrees. Therefore OA and OB are perpendicular lines. Angle between the required lines is 90 degrees. Therefore angle between AOB equal to 90 degrees. Without this formula also we can say the angle between the lines is 90, because quotient of x square plus quotient of y square equal to 90. Therefore angle between the lines is 90 degrees. Okay.